Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the little get to know you here in the opening round scheduled for 10. It's hard to touch Roy Jones Jr. with a clean glove. But if he can, his opponent does have power.
Yes, he does have power, and he has a chance.
Wow, was Roy Jones Jr. stunned right there. I'm personally stunned he didn't go down. But survive, I think he will. Jones's cut is on the cheek, and you can see that it's bothering him a bit right now. That's something we'll keep our eye on.
Hit the body.
Tyson's got a cut around his eye. Looks to be below his eye. That's a flush shot, banking away those body shots with the left hand. Good job. It was sudden. It was fast. It was direct by Roy Jones. Halfway through this round. Roy Jones Jr. showing some defense with the block. Doubling up of the jab by Mike Tyson. Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. And Tyson with a block punch. Jones's plan may be to have more urgency at this point, because that cut of his just has blood streaming all over him.
Well, there's three sides that can be affected. He can be affected himself by seeing his own blood. His opponent can get affected, get a little over-anxious. And the judges, they could be affected a little bit by seeing that kind of blood.
And we come to the end of round number one. Well, we've seen this before, a fighter with a bad cut, and sometimes a fighter that now has a much greater sense of urgency.
Yeah, right now, if he was gambling, if he was in a casino, he's rolling the dice. He's hoping to come up with seven.
There you go.
All the eyes are on him to start this round. Roy Jones Jr.'s legs look just a solid right hand land. So Roy is tagged there, and he's tying up.
You know, Roy loves to develop scenarios offensively, create right in front of you. Well, guess what? He's got to create a defensive scenario right now to get through this moment.
Scoring with the right hand by Roy Jones. And now he's targeting upstairs. Great work offensively landing that combination. Roy Jones Jr.'s bang by a right hand. Oh, big shot. Oh, an explosive headshot there. It is down. Down there, but now he's giving you every indication that he's fresh and ready to go back after him.
Yeah, well, I think he's giving that to you because he is, as you said, just a quick knockdown. But right now, what he's got to be careful for is the same mistake again.
Well, his opponent got away from that uppercut. There's the combo. Solid. How about that? He goes from being the victim to handing out the punishment. So he is able to get up to his feet after that knockdown. But, Teddy, it's what's ahead that's the problem.
Yeah, we're getting a peek right now into his heart, into his soul.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. He just smashed him with that power punch.
That'll teach him to be aggressive with a tall fighter.
Good, smooth work by Roy Jones. That's classic counterpunching.
Yeah, what he did was he pulled that right shoulder back. You know, he just pulled it back, gave him the left shoulder, and then gave him the right hand.
We count down the final moments of this round. Mike Tyson's armor penetrated that time with a hook to the body. And that's the end of round two. Jones is just bubbling over with confidence now. Hey, that happens when you score a knockdown in the last round.
Yeah, it does. I mean, that's nothing greater than that. I mean, that's like somebody, that's like your boss coming to say, hey, here's a bonus out of nowhere. You feel pretty darn good.
Is our boss coming to do that?
No, they don't do that.
Oh, come on.
Calm down now. Calm down. Just breathe. Breathe. Need another round from you. I need you to be busy this round, all right? He caught you with your hands down. Let's box smart and not get caught. Box smart.
Tyson's back. Look at him here in the start of this round. Remember, he got tagged hard in that last round.
Well, that's the reward you get when you have a good camp and you get yourself in top shape.
Keep working the jab. Good, good.
See, the defense pays off as he gets rid of that downstairs. Big left hand from Roy. Mike Tyson digs deep with a big uppercut. Flush right into the head. He missed with that headshot. Roy Jones Jr. is being very patient here, but it's with a plan in mind.
Yeah, it is with a plan in mind, and that's why he's such a successful fighter. He's trying to lure his opponent into a mistake.
Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Halfway through this round here, you can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. That's a clean shot, able to get... Oh, and there you go! And once again, he goes down. The question is, can he rise up again? So now the question comes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So this is where instincts kick in. You got to start moving that head automatically right now. You don't want to stay in the middle.
Oh, and the right hand comes into play by Mike Tyson. Nice work to the midsection with the left. Committing to the body work now, he lands the right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. 10 seconds to go in this third round. Not getting it done with that straight right hand.
All right, breathe. Deep breath. Get some water. You good? You all right? Breathe.
Now start of round number four. A chance to look at Teddy's scorecard and get his insights. Crashes home a headshot after blocking his opponent. Tyson is coming out here after being knocked down in the last round. Teddy, what are... Jones is in a tough spot right now. Boy, he got rocked. Wow, stunned moments ago, but now somehow, wow! Once again, he goes down. Can he survive this? Jones is getting back up to his feet after being knocked down. Mike Tyson's crushed by that shot to the head. How about that angle by Roy Jones? That was good stuff.
Yeah, that's how you break up pressure. Guys is coming at you, you know, train's coming at you. You don't go back on the track because it's gonna hit you. You go off the track on the side, exactly what he did. And that train went right past him.
Body shots. Keep moving around.
And he just holds on there.
You got this one. Don't let him get to you, kid.
This is excessive holding we're seeing here now. They both decide to bring it. Jones is lacking that jab there. He just hasn't committed to throwing it at all.
I mean, that's the most basic thing in the world is to use that jab. That jab does so many things for you. Keeps the guy defensive, and obviously it sets up your offense.
Oh, he turns it over right into a hook. And that's the end of round four. Okay. Roy Jones Jr.'s cut man is going to earn his pay for sure. That is a bad gash.
And I'm wondering what he's using in there. You know, you can only use certain things, Avertine, adrenaline, and thrombin. I'm wondering if he's using legal things right now because that's the kind of cut that tempts you to use crazy glue.
Okay, breathe now. Deep breath, deep breath. Holy shit, you are in control of this fight, man. Don't get careless out there, right? Just keep boxing smart. Keep circling.
As we start a new round, I pose this question to you. Is there any hope for him? He's been knocked down numerous times. Tonight.
Look, there's been great comebacks in this sport. There's always hope. You don't know how deep a man's reserve is inside their soul, inside their mind. But dangerous grounds now to find out.
Turns over that hook and he does damage upstairs. He just missed that shot up top. That's a huge uppercut from Roy Jones Jr. Did you see that? That was a big shot that caught him, and it's a big shot that may end him right here.
That looked like the great pitch of Great Maddox, his sinker ball. Boy, it went down quick.
One, two, three, four.
He gets up after that punch put him down on the canvas.
Now he needs to get on that bicycle and stay away from this guy.
Patience.
That's an impactful right hand by Mike Tyson. Tyson's showing us a real, real solid skill set here with his head movement. Teddy, how much of that is just natural athletic ability and instincts, and how much of that is being trained?
Well, most of it's trained well. If I take a guy off the street, Joe, and he hasn't been taught anything, he's going to throw punches. But usually he's not going to have a good defense. That's something that has to be attained. That's something that has to be...
And yet another big shot comes in. Knocked down again. Unreal.
Now you got to wonder what the corner's thinking. Are they going to stop this?
Jones Jr. is a knockout victim. He couldn't beat the count.